Hi there, and welcome to another little technical video from RRC. As you can see here, I've got my full plating kit set up and ready to go. So I thought now's a great time to take you through each of the individual items here and explain what each of them is made of and what they do. So starting here, we have GP1. This is an alkaline cleaner that I soak my parts in before plating, as it removes all the oils, greases, grimes, whatever you can name. It strips it off the part and leaves lovely clean bare metal ready for plating. This next container contains dry acid salts, dissolved and distilled water. This stage is used primarily to remove any oxide layers that have built up on the steel. Over here is the main plating tank. Now, this solution is made up of distilled water yet again, ammonium chloride and zinc chloride. Every solution on this table is made up of distilled water, and that's because regular tap water contains minerals and other things which can affect the plating. So if you use distilled water, there's no issues with your solution makeup. As well as the solution, in here we have a tank heater so that we can have the solution at 25 degrees. That's the optimal temperature for plating. As in my experience. This wire here goes to an agitation pump. You may be able to see the water moving around here. We have four anodes here spaced evenly around the tank for a nice even plate. You can get away with just two anodes, but four just gives you a nicer even plate, and that's about it for this tank. It's connected to this power supply here, but we'll deal with that later. Oops, put that back on. Now, around here we have the passivation solutions. Now, after the zinc plating is done, you have a lovely shiny layer of zinc, but if left unpassivated, the zinc will go dull over time. So to prevent that, you need to passivate. You can either use blue passivate or yellow passivate. Now, depending how long you leave the part in each of these solutions, you can end up with, in this case, from a nice silvery finish all the way up to, it's hard to describe, a kind of iridescent bluey purpley colour. With the yellow, you can go anywhere from a very, very light yellow all the way up to an almost dirty gold colour. So it just takes a bit of trial and error and experimenting to see what dip times equate to what colours. I've got a little book of how long I submerge parts. I'll show you that later. And now, what we'll do is get on with the demonstration. So over here in this container, I have four bolts which have been sitting in acid overnight to remove the original zinc plating layer. Now, you can see these bolts are totally bare steel now. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to sandblast that one, vapor hone that one, just standard wire wheel on that one, and I'm going to high polish this one so that we can see what each preparation method does to the quality of the zinc plating. So let's get on with that right now. Well, that's the surface finishes locked in, and you can see the variations in texture on them, most notable on the media blasted bolt. Now it's time to give them a soak in the cleaning solution to make sure they are spotless. With the bolts now clean, they are rinsed with more distilled water, and if I see any evidence of any contamination at this point, I will put them back in the cleaner until they are spotless, but they look good to me. So now it's time to put them in the acid. I just want to say at this point that everything I do with these four bolts from this point forward will be done at exactly the same time for the exact same amount of time in each solution, so that the only variable to the surface finish we get at the end is how they were prepared. So let's crack on with it. With the bolts in the acid, you can see lots of tiny bubbles being given off. This is the acid eating into the surface of the steel and leaving a perfectly clean oxide-free layer for the zinc to adhere to. With the bolts now oxide-free and rinsed once more, they are placed into the plating tank. And now to turn on the power. I've set the voltage at a maximum of 5 volts. The voltage doesn't really matter, anywhere between 5 and 10 volts is fine. What really matters is the amps. Now, I've calculated that these four bolts will take approximately 2.43 amps to plate them properly. So let's turn the amperage up till we get to that sweet spot. And there we go. As you can see, we're at 0.8 of a volt and the amperage is set correctly. Now all we have to do is leave this for 20 minutes for the correct plating thickness to build up, and then we'll see what we have. Well, the 20 minutes are up. Now let's turn the power off and get the bolts out of the plating solution and see what we have. As you can see, the bolts are fully plated, and the only one that really stands out as being different is the media blasted one. But we'll know more once we get it rinsed off and dipped in the passivate, and the shine off them will let us see what the surface finish actually is. So the parts are now rinsed and then they go into the acid for a few seconds just to activate the surface again. Then they are rinsed again with more of the distilled water, and then we can go straight round to the blue passivate. Now for me personally, I usually like to plate the silver parts for around 30 seconds. And just as quick as that, 30 seconds is over. Now they get a quick rinse yet again. There we go, and now they are rinsed. They have to dry, and then we can see the final results. Well, the bolts have had a couple of hours to dry, so now let's get them off the heat and onto the bench, and we can have a close look at them and see what's what. So straight away we can see the media blasted bolt has a duller finish than any of the other bolts here. We have a lovely even plate all over the bolt,
So this surface finish would be ideal if you are looking for a nice matte finish, which is in person it's actually quite pleasing to the eye. So I'll be remembering that for future reference. Behind that we have the vapor honed bolt. It's a lot more shiny, but you can still see traces of the honing on the surface. So I don't really recommend this surface finish. It's okay, but it's not the best. So we'll set that down just now. Third, we have just the wire brushed finish, which is more than acceptable. It looks pretty much identical to the zinc plating I took off. So if I can replicate the manufacturer's zinc plating, then I'm quite happy. But the out and out winner is definitely the high polished bolt. The surface is just a lot nicer on this one. It probably doesn't show on camera, but the surface finish is just so much nicer. You can see the slight color variation there. It's just a deeper, nicer, shinier color. So if you really want maximum shine from your zinc plating, mirror polish the bolts first and you'll get a lovely finish.
I'm not going to bother showing the yellow slash gold passivate, as it's just the exact same as what we've got here, except in gold. So what I'm going to do now is to get all this mess tidied up and move on to the next project. And you'll be pleased to know that the weather now is starting to get a bit better. So that means we'll be able to finally get the VFR 400 out on the open road and see how she goes. But until then, I'll keep cracking on with all the other projects I've got lined up for you guys. See you all again soon.